Well, today we're talking about the absolute cheapest Canon L series glass you can buy, 17 to 40. Let's get into it. Well, hey, what's up? My name is Tony. I'm a filmmaker, photographer in the St. Louis area. Today, we are in the middle of the COVID-19 crisis. I hope and pray that you are safe and healthy and your family is all doing well. We live in Missouri, so I am under the work at home and the stay home order, but we're allowed to go to the park and get some fresh air. So that's what I'm doing. We're at a local park right now here in the St. Louis area. And I'm just making sure to stay away from other people and let them enjoy this beauty as well. So the past few videos, I've been talking about some fairly high-end gear, including the RF 70-200, which is a beautiful lens, but not everybody can afford that. And potentially, maybe you shouldn't even buy it. I mean, unless you're a professional photographer, videographer, making money off of this gear, it is really hard for me to suggest people to spend that kind of money to buy the gear. Now, it's great glass, but you don't need to spend that much money to be able to have excellent gear to get great quality photo and video. So that's where today comes in. We're gonna talk about the EF 17 to 40. Now this lens came out in 2003. To put that in perspective, the iPhone, the original iPhone came out in 2007. 2007, so this is 4 years older than the original iPhone. But this is the good news. Lenses do not age nearly as fast as technology. Now, if you were to look at a camera from 2003, I'd say it's probably time to move on. But with lenses, you still get great glass, you still get great quality, and there's just not a lot of technical hardware in there. That'll probably change with this new RF lens when it comes to like firmware updates and all the technical side that it works with the R system. But for now, these EF lenses, even dating all the way back to 2003, are still incredible. And whether it's made in 2003 or 2018, you're gonna get some good quality glass with some of this EF glass. So that's why we're talking about this today. The 17 to 40 is ultra wide. You can use it for vlogs, you can use it for interior, you can use it for landscape, all sorts of things. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna talk to you about a few things that I love about this lens, and then I'm gonna talk about who do I think this lens is for and maybe somebody who shouldn't buy it. So let's get into talking about the things I love about this lens. First thing, obvious right out of the gate, it is dirt cheap when it comes to L glass. Dirt cheap. You can buy this from Canon, refurbished, for around 500 bucks. That comes with a warranty from Canon. Now, if you want to pick one up used, on eBay, you can get one from anywhere from like $200 to $300, which is crazy. You can't buy EFS glass that cheap. So the price is a huge selling point when it comes to this lens. Let's talk about a few more things that I love about it, and it's kind of the features and the things that you get when you buy an L series glass. First one is it comes with weather sealing on this lens. That means that you can use it in the rain. I've had it out in the rain, no trouble at all. Now you wanna stick a filter on this side and that kind of seals the weather sealing, but you can just use a regular UV filter if you're gonna do that, and that kind of seals it to make it 100% weatherproof. Another thing you get is that better quality glass. You're gonna get really good quality glass when you're talking about L series glass. And you're gonna get a little bit beefier product. It's just gonna be a little bit better built because it's an L series glass. Another thing that I really like about this lens is the size. You know, the size and the weight of this, it's not too big. It'll fit in my bag just fine. You know, if you can compare this to the 16 to 35, this one is a little bit shorter, might be a little bit fatter, but it's quite a bit smaller, like lengthwise. And so that makes it really good for balancing on a small gimbal. It pairs really well with the EOS R, which is a little bit smaller body, and it's just an all around good buy. The other thing that I really, really love about this lens, and this is particular to me, is that I love the fact that it is a 77 millimeter filter size. And that's a big deal to me because I use ND filters a lot for video. Like right now, I have a 77 millimeter ND filter on my camera. And the nice thing about 77 millimeter is this lens is a 77 millimeter. My 70 to 200 is a 77 millimeter. My 24 to 105, 85 millimeter. There's so many lenses are that classic 77 millimeter filter size, which means I don't need to buy an extra ND filter compared to the 16 to 35, which is even bigger. It might be like 82 or even bigger than that. I don't need to buy step up rings, which I've got a stack of these things and they're annoying and they get lost. And then I can't use my ND filter on the lens that I need. It just makes it so much easier when I have the same size filter size for all of my lenses. So that's another really big advantage of this lens. Now, who do I think that this lens is for? It's for a number of people. First of all, like I said earlier, maybe somebody who doesn't want to go out and spend $3,000 on the RF 35 millimeter, the 15 to 35. I mean, $3,000 is a ton of money. Like, I, as a professional, have a hard time justifying $3,000 for a ultra wide lens that I'm not going to use for much more than vlogging. Just somebody who doesn't want to spend a lot of money. Maybe you're just getting into photography. Maybe you're just a hobbyist and that's all you want to do. You want to get some good landscape photos. You want to get some good interiors. You don't want to be limited to not having an ultra wide lens. That's the first person, someone who doesn't want to spend a lot of money. Another person that I think that this would be really great for is the lightweight traveling photographer, videographer. This lens is small, it's compact. 17 to 40 will get you pretty much that whole small, wide angle to standard that you would need. 17 millimeters get you really, really wide, but 40, you could even do portraits with this if you really wanted to. I know some people shoot at 35 millimeters for the portraits, and even at f4, it's not that big of a deal. You can still get some beautiful blur. The other person that I think this might be really beneficial to is somebody who just does a lot of like real estate photography. Somebody who just needs that wide angle room. They're not really worried about low light because of the F4. You're gonna crank it up to F7.1 or whatever it is anyways to make sure that everything's nice and crisp. So you don't necessarily feel limited by the low light capability. But you still need that wide angle. And then, bonus, somebody who's doing landscape, if you're out in the field taking photos of mountains and you want this big expanse, of an area, this lens will be excellent for that. Okay, so who do I think that this lens is not recommended for? First one, I think, is wedding videographers, photographers. The low light performance just is not that great. You're gonna need a little bit faster lens. And when you're talking about ceremonies that are really low lit, when you're talking about dark and moody reception halls, this lens just isn't gonna cut it. I'd suggest getting in something a little bit faster. And you don't wanna be switching lenses all day long. So I try and take as few of lenses as possible into a wedding scene when I go. The other person I don't think that this lens is for is if you need a really incredibly sharp lens. This lens is a little bit on the softer side, which is fine for me because I like that cinematic look. But if you need a really super sharp image, this one probably is not the right lens for you. And then the only other person that I could think that would not enjoy this lens is somebody who likes to push the cutting edge of technology. You really enjoy your RF glass because you can update the firmware and it comes with all of the nice new glass and features and things like that. This lens will probably leave you a little disappointed. All right, well, let's get into some footage. I'll show you what you can do with this lens, what it looks like. I'm gonna be shooting on my EOS R with the adapter. And we'll just kind of see what we can do. Let's do it. You say, take me on a treasure hunt. I long for something new. Have you heard the fairies when they sing and dance? Oh, I wish it was me. Trust you when you say that. All right, guys, well, I'm a big fan of this 17-40 for all of the reasons that we talked about. If this video is helpful for you, I would encourage you to like it. Leave a comment if you've got some questions about this lens in particular. If you would like to see some more footage, anything, just leave a comment. Let me know what you're thinking. And if you haven't already, I'd love for you to subscribe to my channel. Lots of gear, lots of tutorials, lots of fun stuff regarding cameras. All right, guys, hope you have a great week. We'll see you in the next one. Well, it's a new day, a new Colorado t-shirt, and I forgot when I was filming in the park to do any kind of vlog style shooting. So this is at 17 millimeters. I've just got my little handle vlog setup. If you're interested in that, I'll put up a little card and a description in the bottom. This is my vlog setup, but I'm using this lens, the 17-40, on my setup instead of my 10-18. And you can kind of see it looks pretty good. You can spin it around. How's the shake look without IS? We didn't talk about that. There's no IS, and so the stabilization may not be as quite as stable, but because it's so wide, it might work. Okay, bye.